see now the front of the White House from our camera on the roof of the CNN Bureau. Speaker still addressing the crowd of people gathered behind the White House, these 3,000 to 5,000 demonstrators who marched from October Square about 3 miles away down the Moscow Ring Road, breaking through police lines repeatedly as police fired tear gas and rubber bullets, climbing like so many ants over water trucks and barbed wire that barricaded the White House and retaken their demonstrating position. We just heard ousted Vice President Alexander Rutskoy, formerly a Yeltsin crony and pal, a Yeltsin supporter at one time, now the most vicious enemy of the Russian president, ordering these people to form into brigades and attack the Moscow mayor's office and the television broadcasting center of Ostankino. A big crowd still milling around at Kutuzovsky Prospect here near the Moscow River, around the White House with this police interior ministry. This is a picture of the Moscow mayor's office right now. It's adjacent to the White House, just across the street. The former headquarters of Comic-Con, which was the Soviet bloc trading organization, until the Soviet bloc fell apart. Inside that building, several thousand of these interior ministry troops have been billeted since this crisis really came to a head several nights ago, when a cordon was thrown up around the White House, and several thousand troops of the interior ministry began blocking the re-entry of demonstrators to the White House and the exit of people inside the building, trying to force the exit of people inside the building. For a time, all electricity, telephones, heat, and hot water were turned off to the White House. Those services had recently been turned back on as negotiations began in the auspices of the Russian Orthodox Patriarch Alexei II. There were hopes for a time that there might be some sort of negotiated breakthrough in this standoff. Those talks apparently are still going on, but are in recess at this hour, according to Mr. Rutskoy's people. The talks are going on with the deputy, Voronin, still meeting with the government side. There's a picture of troops going back up in front of the mayor's office, probably having heard this call from Rutskoy for an attack on the building. There seems, at this point, no major defection from the side of the Interior Ministry to the demonstrators, as the former vice president had called for in his brief remarks to this crowd.
Steve, Rutskoy certainly appeared to be trying to fire up the crowd as much as he could. Would you tend to believe that they are of the mood right now to follow his orders?
Clearly, the people who are trained military men who are inside the White House are in the mood to do that. Guns were passed out from the White House, and there were a lot of people, the so-called defenders of the White House, paramilitary groups inside there who were seen coming out of the building with guns as that gunfire was going off. We showed you the tape out there. So certainly they're in the mood. But you can see this crowd from our live camera at the back of the White House. And these don't look like the kinds of people who can do much but march en masse. These are mainly elderly people. You see a lot of women in the crowd. None of these people, of course, are armed. And certainly not the kind of people who could lead their way back into the cars moving now in front of the White House. These are black Volgas, the kind of cars that would carry Russian officials. Obviously, we don't know who would have been in those cars if it were some of the leadership from either the parliament or Rutskoy moving away from the White House. It would be very indicative either that they're going someplace in a hurry to talk to somebody or they're getting out of the White House quickly, hearing what's coming. We can't see him right now, but speaking through that bullhorn is Ruslan Khasbulatov, chairman of the parliament. Just listen to what he has to say.
Law and order that Muscovites, our people, our nation, will not allow anyone to usurp the power. And we have won. We have prevailed. I want to thank you all for being here. It's you guys who have defended the honor of this country. You have defended, you have proved to all foreign propaganda workers who have been telling everyone that we are saved, that we report to a dictatorship. You have shown them all that we are free people, that we're people who have honor and dignity, and we will not tolerate any usurpers for a single minute. I'm calling on our courageous warriors to bring troops here, to bring tanks here, in order to attack the Kremlin and all the usurpers and the former criminals, including Yeltsin. Yeltsin should be put in the Matrosskaya Tishina prison, and all his sidekicks should be driven underground. There should be an open trial. I ask everyone to get organized in order to attack and seize the mayor's office and the Ostankino Television Centre. This is a beehive of criminals, of villains, of counter-revolutionaries. Dear friends, we today are beginning the most resolute attack against the bulwarks of criminals who have seized power from the people. I would like to thank you so much, my dear fellow countrymen, my dear Russians, my dear Muscovites. Thank you so much indeed.
It was Ruslan Khasbulatov, chairman of the banned Russian parliament, echoing the calls of Alexander Ruskoy, calling on these people to form up and attack the Moscow mayor's office just across the street. And across town, way across town, the Russian television broadcasting center of Ostankino, he also made a call on these people to form up and attack the Kremlin, where Boris Yeltsin has his office. A very, very fiery and dangerous speech at this moment, because these people still are surrounded by thousands of armed interior ministry troops. Picture now from our roof location where I'm speaking from, the Moscow's mayor's office, in that picture with orange water trucks in the front. Those have been put there late last week when the interior minister formed this cordon around the White House, and has now been broken by these demonstrators. Some 3,000 to 5,000 of them took a long march from October Square and the statue of Vladimir Lenin along Moscow's Ring Road, breaking through police line after police line, going attacked from tear gas canisters and rubber bullets, and finally reaching the White House, where they have regained their demonstration place at the back.
Steve, in light of Khasbulatov's speech a moment ago, and as you put it quite correctly, a dangerous speech,
where does the military stand in all of this?
The military officially stands four square behind Boris Yeltsin. His defense minister, Pavel Grachev, has repeatedly said that the military stands behind Boris Yeltsin as commander-in-chief. We've seen no defection to this point from the interior ministry troops. A separate ministry from the Ministry of Defense. The military here is divided into the armed forces designed to repulse attacks from abroad. That would be the Army, the Navy, the Air Force, and the Interior Ministry, which is effectively a police force inside the country. But these are heavily armed soldiers, not just policemen, and they're trained to deal with problems just like this. We can see now at the back of the White House some trucks that were commandeered by these demonstrators as they marched toward the White House.
Difficult to see what's going on. Obviously, those trucks, which are troop carriers, have been brought in to move people. We don't know how many trucks they have at their disposal, but we can see from our vantage point
on the bridge, there are perhaps 6 to 8 to 10 trucks at their disposal. Ruskoy is down in the crowd, apparently, with a megaphone, trying to organize these people. You can see them forming up in line, standing at attention now. One of the men with a helmet on, others in civilian clothes.
All right, Steve, some local cable operators will be cutting away for a commercial message at this time, CNN, and so will we. We will continue our live coverage from Moscow in just a moment. About a half an hour ago, the shooting...